It was absolutely one of my goals that, you know, I was hoping that we would play well enough that, you know, people would get their opportunity to achieve their goals. And when they got to do that, you know, me being able to step into this role, and it was a dream.
The 2023 season is upon us. With that brings new opportunities for the Tennessee football program. For some, like new offensive coordinator Joey Halsley, that means new roles.
There's no better environment, there's no better fan base. And to be able to step in, one, I'm excited, but two, I also understand the responsibility of what goes along with being the offensive coordinator here.
Family is extremely important for this coaching staff. You can see it in their connection with the players off the field.
The whole family thing that everyone pitches in recruiting, that's probably the most overused thing ever, is a pretty real thing when we talk about it here. Joe went running over there and gave my wife a big hug, and like, he was holding her before I even got over there. All the guys wanted to come see her. They'd been asking about her. So it just that room, man, they're awesome. It matters, especially in that room when typically you got one guy playing. If there's contention in the room to start, once you get to fall and there's truly only one guy getting the main reps now, like, it gets sour really fast. So the fact that these guys all like root for each other and care about each other while competing, it makes it a lot of fun to be a part of.
There will be a lot of competition this spring, and that starts with the expectations set by the coaching staff.
Talked to the guys yesterday in our UTA meeting, like, you know, a lot of people would come in and try to say, like, we got to be better, we got to do this. I was like, no, you guys that were here, you were really good. You were the best offense in the country. Now we have to remember that we don't just get to do that, so don't forget the work that went into it.
52-49. Tennessee is still undefeated.
When they buy in, when they do things the right way, when they care about each other, when they work, like, that's the type of rewards you get. You get those type of moments, you get that type of feeling. And there's a lot of competition out there on that field, so it's a stepping stone getting you to be able to earn the right to have those feelings, to have those moments. You're earning those out here in January, February, March, you know, all the way leading up to the season, because it does not just happen. You don't show up, and that's the type of thing that happens. You got to earn those moments, you got to earn those feelings. My only point is, like, you hear me say it all the time, right? Like, I'm not in the business of building robots.
It's obviously different. There's been positives and negatives to both. It's always fun when you just have to worry about your position, but now getting to have a bigger say in how we're installing, what we're putting in, the plays that are getting run, the plays that are getting called.
You can't judge the outcomes. You got to just judge your decision making all day.
It's been a fun addition to the demands of the job, but you know, quarterbacks will still always be where my passion is, and nothing's gonna change there.
Yeah, I played for Coach Height at Oklahoma, then I worked with him there, and we've been together the whole rest of the way.
Coach Halsley and I have a deep history together.
He molds his scheme, he molds what he has to fit his players.
Your right foot out of it, start.
He's been absolutely vital, intricate, been a great mentor for everything moving forward.
You're gonna have to squeeze it because the kit block has to happen.
He's tunneling
it. So you're gonna have to take your time anyways.
Coach Halsley has played a tremendous role in our development at the quarterback room. There isn't too many quarterback coaches around the country that can actually have fun with you and also, you know, coach you the same way.
Celebrate, Joe! Now go celebrate!
Last year, there was no doubt, Hendon Hooker was a guy for Tennessee football. But now it's Joe Milton's time to take the reins.
He has become a leader. He was a guy in the past that probably would have told you he was, but now he sees what it really takes to be a leader.
Real work right here, man.
Joe knows this is his time, and he's determined to make the most of this opportunity.
Hey, yo, we got to win. We got to win. Fourth quarter. We can't get this day back. Oshon 2, 1, 2.
Oshon.
I think it's one of the great stories in all of college football, the maturity that Joe has had since his arrival, his ability to want to get better, understanding where he can get better, and then working extremely hard to perfect his craft every single day.
I think the guys respect the fact that Joe could have had the opportunity to leave at any time when Hendon ended up taking over the job that first year. And he stayed and he stuck it out. Not only did he stick it out, he was a positive energy within the building. He was always prepared to play.
I started at Michigan in 2020. You know, I was having success early.
Going over the top against that secondary on the next play.
And I thought that, you know, it'll be easy to just keep doing the same thing over and over, week by week.
We saw Joe Milton get up limping
And some pain after that hit.
They're taking a look at him on the sideline.
You know, after I got hurt the second time, it kind of took a toll on me. I was kind of in the mindset of like, man, do I actually want to do this? Once I found that way and I got out through my adversities, I told myself, once I get that opportunity again, I'm going to go hard.
Champs on two, champs on two, 1-2.
He was always working hard in workouts, working hard in the meeting room.
Listen up, and we're starting slow, everybody rolling, everybody pushing each other, and everybody grinding, man.
So I think the guys see that, and they know that that's a guy that's truly invested in this program, because if he was just about himself, he would have left.
After Hendon started starting, you know, he came to my house that week of the game, and we had a long, deep talk about who I was as a person and who was he as a person. That conversation was very important for us and for the team.
This is where you break tackles at right here. What we got? Break it up. Break it up.
I lead by example. I lead by, you know, talking to guys. I can tell guys what to do.
We don't put our hands up on our hips. That's how you show weakness.
Ooh. You know, also when a coach tells me to do something, I'm able to do it in the right way.
Joe has done a really good job of continuing to mature, but his energy, his presence, his competitiveness, and his focus has been felt inside of our building every single day this offseason.
Spring football is back. You can feel the opportunity in the air. For this Tennessee defense, they're looking to build on what they accomplished at the Orange Bowl.
First pass, and he is torn down.
Gotta be so impressed with how Tennessee's defense is held up tonight. Beasley has had himself a night.
Linebacker Aaron Beasley finished the 2022 season on a high note, stuffing the stat sheet with 12 tackles, 2 sacks, and 4 tackles for loss. Now he looks to take a more active leadership role in his senior year.
Defensively, Aaron Beasley thrusting himself into a leadership role.
Being the best teammate, the best leader I can possibly be. I feel like, you know, I've been put in that role for a reason. You know, I feel like me doing that and me honing in on that will only, you know, sky's the limit for our defense, I feel like.
Good work. Find where he's going, snagging out. What you worry about, that's why you feel you worry about making more contact.
I'm not really vocal, you know, I'm improving on that though. I'm gonna push guys, encourage guys, you know, and try to inspire the guys around me to, you know, want to go hard every day and really want to work.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
I'm inspiring them to know that they can do what they want with this game as well. So, I feel like that's the biggest thing, connecting with my brothers, you know, having a relationship with them, having a, you know, bonding with them, you know, getting to know them. I feel like that's the way I lead off the field.
Spring ball, the second quarter of our off season. This is one of the best times of year. We get a chance to go out and grow individually and collectively as a football program.
The expectation for this offense just overall is to be the best offense in the country. That standard never changes. That's what it's been. That's what it's going to be.
Everybody's just trusting in one another. Not too many teams around the country that can actually say that and do that at the same time.
Just improving off of last year, playing with a lot of swag, a lot of juice, a lot of urgency, man. I feel like, you know, we can do whatever we want to in this year in this league.
All right, teams that hope, teams that believe, and then teams that expect, right? You got to work in a way that gives you a chance to expect, all right?
New roles, same expectations. This spring, Tennessee football was to take the next step as a program, and you can watch it all right here on The Juice.